Let's do a self-exploration on Atmanirvritti's chapter 3. Seeing. For this exploration, it would be a good idea to sit in front of a wall and close your eyes. Imagine yourself to be a little baby lying in the cradle. Asleep soundly. You are peace itself, peace devoid of thoughts, feelings, sensations, perceptions, simply peace, an unconditioned mind. Devoid of any labels. You are a bundle of pure innocence, devoid of any conditioning. Rest there in that peace. Relax, melt, sink into that peace. The baby awakens and slowly opens its eyes. Open your eyes and look at the wall. Look at the wall innocently. When you open your eyes, the form of the wall appears. Now close your eyes again. The form of the wall disappears. In your direct experience, devoid of logic or deduction, in your pure direct experience, does the wall have an existence independent of your seeing it? Open your eyes again. Seeing appears. Form appears. Close your eyes. Seeing disappears. Form disappears. In your direct experience, does the wall have an independent existence apart from your seeing it? remember, you are a baby that is not conditioned by this world, that has no labels. In your pure innocence of seeing things as they are, in your direct experience, does the wall have an independent existence apart from your seeing? Now, without opening your eyes, just imagine the wall. Even in your imagination, does the wall have an independent existence apart from seeing? Can you separate the object of sight from seeing? Can you separate the object of sight from seeing? An unseen form is never ever experienced, not even in dreams. An unseen form is never ever experienced. Do you realize that seeing cannot be separated from form? Do you realize that form cannot be separated from seeing? Form is seeing itself. Seeing is form. Now slowly open your eyes and look at the wall again. Investigate what is it that seeing is made up of. Is seeing different from knowing? Is knowing different from being aware? Is being aware different from witnessing? Notice that seeing cannot be separated from the awareness to which it arises. Seeing cannot be separated from the knowingness that knows it. Seeing cannot be separated from the consciousness that is conscious of it. Seeing cannot be separated from the witness that is witnessing it. Can you draw a line where awareness stops and seeing begins? Can you draw a line where knowingness stops and seeing begins? Can you draw a line where witnessing stops and seeing begins? Can you draw a line where consciousness stops and seeing begins? Awareness, knowingness, witnessing, consciousness are simply synonyms. We cannot draw a line between seeing and our own self. Seeing cannot be separated from consciousness, from myself. I, the consciousness, cannot be separated from seeing. Consciousness is seeing itself. Awareness, knowingness, consciousness, witnessing are simply the functions of the absolute reality. You are perceiving nothing but the absolute reality right now. Can the illusion of the sight of a wall exist hereafter?